Dear Commissioner General Formigoni, dear Special Commissioner Pisapia, dear Madame Bracco, President of the Expo Company, dear Giuseppe Sala, CEO of the Expo Company, dear Commissioner Generals, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends. Well, I am very happy to see you once again at this second International Participants Meeting as we continue our preparation work to stage the 2015 World Expo in Milan. Since our last meeting, the organizers have made significant progress, which they are here to present today. Indeed, this past year has proven quite positive for Expo Milan 2015, and therefore for our organization and for all of us. This is because international participants have demonstrated a particularly high level of interest to take part in this world stage, tackling our common challenge of feeding the planet energy for life. I wholeheartedly share the satisfaction of the Commissioner General, President Formigoni, and of the CEO, Mr. Sala, for this achievement of the Expo, and for the level of interest that you continue to demonstrate, all of you. I would like to take this opportunity to also express my sincere thanks to the Special Commissioner, Mr. Pisapia, for his support. During the course of this meeting, 10 countries or more will sign the participation contract. We are looking forward to these commitments, which are the necessary premise for a successful Expo. As the number of participants continues to increase at an impressive pace, I am delighted to see that the opportunities for preparing an outstanding presence in Milan are becoming more real and more concrete by the day. Just 1 year ago, on the occasion of the first international participant meetings, the Milan 2015 organizers had just broken ground in the Expo site. Today, we are going to visit the site and we are going to see the progress which has been made on the site. I have been there myself only a few weeks ago, and I have witnessed a steady progress. At the same time, a number of international participants have already identified their pavilion locations in the site. This is a further major achievement that will help focus our efforts in a constructive and project-driven direction. As the preparation ramps out, the challenges we all face will only increase. However, I am confident that in this phase of preparation, the interest and dedication of the international participants are a strong motivating factor to focus our efforts into the common goal of opening the World Expo in May 2015. I strongly recommend, and I ask all the participants to concentrate their efforts on the preparation of their participation according to the established calendar. There is no time to waste. An Expo is a common project. We should all work at a steady pace in order to meet the challenges of finishing on time. But let me share a few additional good news. Expo Milan 2015, the government of Italy, which has been giving a permanent support to this project, and the BIE, we signed the SEA agreement, which is a critical milestone in the preparation of the Expo. With this agreement, we have established the legal framework for all the benefits and the guarantees that Milan Expo 2015 will provide to the participants. This is a crucial aspect of Expo BIE cooperation, of the Government of Italy BIE cooperation, and its ultimate goal is not only to facilitate your presence here, but to enable it to be as successful as possible. The theme represents another major area of progress. Feeding the planet, energy for life, embodies many challenges that we all face as we work to secure a sustainable supply of food and a healthy food chain. At the same time, it incorporates some of the most profound cultural elements through agricultural practices, food traditions, social and artistic aspects of what and how we eat. There is a lot that the organizers and the participants can do to bring this theme to life in all of its different facets. The Commissioner General of the Expo has already mentioned, but he and his team have prepared a conceptual document of the principles and values of the Expo that constitutes an essential platform for formulating ideas and proposals that will be the basis for future commitments and the final declaration of Expo 2015, which is going to be the intellectual legacy and the action plan for the future after the Expo. As you know, the BIE continues to stress its significance and its key role in creating a truly exciting Expo. To this end, we encourage the organizers to design and develop ideas that will improve the tool set for the future that we have available today to make the theme more prominent, more engaging, and more relevant to a wide variety of visitors, but also to participants. I'm truly delighted to see that Expo 2015 has taken up this challenge and prepared an excellent and comprehensive document, the theme guide, also mentioned by the Commissioner General, that will support all of you as you design your theme presentation and exhibition. This initiative is unprecedented in the history of Expos and could serve as model for future Expos. The theme should not be perceived as a constraining factor, but rather as a way to enhance what you wish to showcase about your country, in addition to teaching the visitors about your country, your community, your cities, your nature, and so on. You will be able to showcase achievements that will be unexpected and hence even more powerful. Your country will draw the visitors in while your theme will leave a lasting impression. The closer the pavilion will be to the theme, the higher the quality of the visitors' experience. Before I leave you to the upcoming working sessions, I would like to stress that we are at a very crucial time. Expo Milan 2015 has gained great momentum. It enjoys the support of the government and it continues to be driven by the creative Italian spirit and the Milanese solidarity. This is a great recipe for success. I wish you all good works and fruitful working sessions over the coming day. Thank you very much for your attention.